Praise the Lord, saints.
Hallelujah.
Amen. It's good to be back into the house of prayer one more time. Amen. Just want to tell the Lord, thank you for bringing us across another day.
Amen.
Up until this present time, we want the saints of God to touch and agree and pray that God will word my mouth and give a thought in the word of God. And we are studying lesson 3, June 18th, 2023. A victorious kingdom. A victorious kingdom. And we know victorious means someone who has won victory in a struggle. How many of us have been in some struggles? And God has brought us out victorious.
Amen.
We were the winner.
Amen.
Amen. If you're on the Lord's side, we're on the winning side. God has never lost a battle or war. Amen. A victorious kingdom. Amen. We're talking about Jesus' kingdom in our lesson. And he's wanting his disciples to be victorious. When they go out, he wants them to be winners and not losers. Amen. And the golden text say, he ordained 12 special men. Amen. He wanted 12 disciples. Amen. He had a whole lot of followers.
Mm-hmm.
Everywhere he went, he had a whole lot of followers, but he picked 12 men to be his disciples slash his apostles, that they should be with him. Amen. If we are going to be one of Jesus' disciples, we got to draw nigh to him. We got to be with him. Amen. We got to fast. We got to pray. Amen. We got to read the word of God and let it become a part of us. Amen. Why? Because you really want to be one of his disciples and that he might send them forth to preach. Amen. Who he calls, he qualifies. God will give you in the self-same hour what he wants you to say. Amen. So let us go into our lesson. Mark 3:13. And he goeth, and Jesus goeth up into a mountain. Amen. Jesus had to get away. Even Jesus had to get to himself. Amen. And when you get to yourself, you know you're emulating Jesus, what he did. He drew away from the people. Amen. So he could get into the spirit. Amen. And calleth unto him whom he would. Amen. Out of all of those followers, he just called out 12. Amen. And calleth unto him he would. And they came unto him. When you get the call, you got to be obedient. When you hear Jesus call you, you better take notice. Amen. Why? Because he will not strive with man always. You ought to count yourself blessed when Jesus called you for you to be an instrument in his hand. And this is what the disciples were. They were chosen men. Amen. God called out. Amen. To do a work for him. He wanted them to preach and to teach. Amen. And to cast out demons. Amen. He gave them that authority to cast out devils. Amen. And saints of God, before you go out, you better make sure you fast it up. Because on one occasion in the Bible, they tried to cast out some devil. Y'all remember what happened to them? Them demons beat them naked. Amen. This is the reason we got to be fasted up, prayed up. Amen. You can't just go out. Amen. On your own, but you got to have that divine guidance that Jesus gives. You got to have that divine authority. Amen. Verse 14. And he ordained 12. Amen. God put his spirit. Amen. He was leading, guided, directing. Saints of God, don't we need divine guidance? We need direction. Amen. One scripture say he called some, but some ran. And that means He called them, but they didn't get the message. They didn't listen for what he wanted them to do. Saints of God, we got to listen what God would have us to do. He said he ordained 12 that they should be with him and that they might, that he might send them forth to preach. Amen. He gave them a message. Saints of God, if God give you a message, you can't add to it. You can't take from it. You got to say it just like God wants you to say it. On one occasion, Mother Ayers was preaching. And so when she stopped preaching, she just sat down. So this lady went over to her and started praying for her and said, get on back up. She said, no, when Jesus quit, I quit. You know, if Jesus don't give you any more, then Jesus will. Say that and sit down. Amen. Don't add or take anything from your tent. And to have power to heal sickness and to cast out devils. This is the reason they had to draw nigh unto Jesus, so he would give them that authority that they would need to cast out devils. Amen. So many people say, yeah, the devil got power. Them demons are bad. How many know Jesus? Amen. He got all power. Amen. And the devil only have the power that Jesus allowed him to have. Amen. And these disciples, Jesus was equipping them with the authority and with the power that they need to go out and be faithful witnesses. Amen. When they go out to witness, amen, they can accomplish. Amen. They can be victorious. They can be soul winners for Christ. Amen. So many times, saints of God, on Saturday morning, we might hear that knock on that door, and we peep out, and we know who is at the door. Amen. Saints of God, but we got to be faithful witnesses for the Lord. Amen. They indoctrinate their children. They can go out. That's what the apostolic teaching. We ought to be training our children, teaching them. Amen. Why? Because when they go out to school, amen, they can be witnesses for the Lord. And a lot of times, I feel like God have us on these jobs and in these certain positions to be witnesses for them. Amen. We aren't just there to make money, but we are there to be witnesses for the Lord. Be soul winners for the Lord. A lot of times, we don't have to say anything, but our life speak out for us. Amen. We don't have to put sanctification on our chest or on our back. Amen. But the life that you live, amen, will speak enough for you. Amen. Verse 10. It says, and Simon, he surnamed Peter. Simon, Jesus surnamed Peter. He gave him another name to go with his name. Simon Peter. Amen. 17. James, the son of Zebedee, letting us know that James' father was Zebedee, and John, the brother of James, this was his brother, amen, and he surnamed him Boanerges. Hopefully I said it right. Pray for us, son. Which is the sons of thunder. Why did Jesus call these brothers Boanerges? Why did he call them that? Because of their personality. They had aggressive personalities. Amen. Because on one occasion they went through a village in Samaria. And these people, they didn't receive Jesus' message. So these two brothers say, Jesus, let us call fire down from heaven and destroy all of them. Aggressive behavior. Aggressive personality. But Jesus stepped in and he rebuked them. He said, I didn't come to take man's life, but I came to be a life I'm gonna make a people out of you. How many God, you want God to make a people out of you because he ain't through with us yet. Amen. God got some more he wants you to do. Supposing when Peter just cut Caiaphas' servant off, God would have just kicked him to the sack. When Peter denied Jesus three times, he just kicked him to the sack. But God still wanted a work to work through Peter. Amen. And when Peter denied him, he was so sorrowful, amen, that Jesus went to him and let him know everything gonna be all right. Amen. And don't you know, can't you see how Jesus was working through Peter, and Peter became the head apostle. He became, and that's why, saints of God, you let God work on you. Amen. You get in the scripture, you fast, you pray. Amen. Because you want to be an instrument in God's hand. And just by chance, if God use you to cast out devils and to preach the word of God, don't get the big head. Don't take the glory for yourself. But glory be to who? God. You let God have all the glory. Amen. And then he say, and John, the brother of James, and he surnamed them, the two brothers, amen, aggressive behavior, brother. Them were the sons of thunder. Amen. Don't cross them, brothers. Amen. Jesus is still ain't through with them yet. Amen. Verse 18. He also called Andrew and Philip and Bartholomew and Matthew and Thomas and James, the son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus, and Simon the Canaanite. Amen. All of these Jesus was calling. And some of the disciples, amen, had the same name. That's the reason Jesus added a surname to it, as a distinction between the two. Amen. And Andrew and Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus, and Simon the Canaanite, and Judas Iscariot. So many times, our pastor say, Jesus called 12 apostles. One of them was a devil. Amen. Don't you know Jesus already know? He knew who he was calling. Amen. Jesus don't call you because you qualified. He called you, amen, and when he called you, he qualified you into what he wants you to be. Amen. Judas Iscariot, amen, which also betrayed him, and they went into an house. Amen. They had to get together with Jesus. Amen. This was a teachable moment. Jesus wanted to teach them, instruct them. Amen. And saints of God, when we get the instruction, we can't be careless hearers. Amen. We got to retain what Jesus is telling us. Amen. How many know so many times you've been in church years and years and years? Amen. And one get up expounding on the word. How many know when you hear it wrong?
Amen.
When they say it wrong, you know. Oh, no, that ain't how that goes. Amen. They added. They left something out. Amen. That's how you know you're in the word of God. Amen. You're in training. Amen. Why? Because you rehearse it in your spirit. Amen. Verse 6b. And he went round about the villages teaching. Amen. These 12 were still with him. Amen. And while they were with Jesus, they was observing him. Amen. Just Jesus was our best example. Amen. They could watch how Jesus did. Amen. Jesus said, the works that I do, ye shall do also, but greater works. They were going to do more than Jesus. Amen. He wanted them to do what he did and more works and greater works. Amen. Why? Because they could go here and there. Amen. And teach and preach and cast out devils. Verse 7. And he called unto him the 12 and began to send them forth two by two, and gave them power over unclean spirits. Amen. Jesus had fully equipped them on what they needed to do. Now it's time for them to go out and be fruitful witnesses, victorious witnesses. Amen. Why? Because by them going out, amen, preaching and teaching and casting out devils, amen, they'll help building up the kingdom of God. Amen. Verse 8. It say, and commanded them that they should take nothing for their journey. Amen. Our pastor brought it out. Jesus wanted them to know they had to totally depend on Jesus. He wanted them to know, I got you. Whatever you need, I'm going to supply your every need. Amen. And the reason he sent them out two by two, he said two is better than one.
Amen.
One found what? The others can help pick them up. Amen. I used to sort of play with people a little bit. I say, Bishop Curtis and I, two is better than one. If he fall, I can't pick him up, but I can rope him. God is good. Amen. But I'm going to be there for him, and he's going to be there for me. Amen. So he told them, don't take nothing for your journey. You totally depend on me. He said, you just put your sandals on. Get a staff, amen. Yeah. Don't even take no script. Don't get your scripture, amen. You get, because in the same hour, Jesus was going to speak through them. Amen. He said, don't take no script, no bread. Amen. How many know preachers like to eat? He told them, don't take no bread. I got you. Amen. No money in your purse. Amen. You just go there. Amen. This was the initial sending out. But the next time you sent them out, he told them to take a script. Take what they needed. Amen. But now, the initial time, Jesus is letting them know, I'm going to supply all of your needs according to your riches and glory. I got you. Amen. He said, but be shod with sandals. You put sandals on your feet. How many know Jesus wore sandals too? Amen. And not put on two coats. Amen. Just get one. Amen. Don't try to carry. Sometimes you can be overloaded. Amen. He wanted them to take just enough. Amen. 10. And he said unto them, in what place soever ye enter into and how, there abide till ye depart from that place. Amen. He's telling them, don't go to a house and then you want to take up and leave and go find another house and another house and another house. He wanted them to be content in that house. Amen. Why? Because he had a word for that house. Amen. He had a message for that house. Amen. And like our pastor so many times say, when we go into a house, amen, you want to be productive there. Amen. And you can tell when people really don't want you there. Amen. So we're going to get to that a little bit further down. Amen. But so many times Bishop Curtis and I had went into a sick room. We went there, you know, to sort of make them feel good. How can we know they turn it around and they make us feel good? Amen. Why? Because they made us feel so welcome. Amen. And so many times when we went to Mother Clarissa Todd's house and her sister's house, amen, they made us feel so good, amen. And they would tell the pastor, oh, you bringing me my spiritual food. They were glad we were bringing the Lord's Supper unto them, amen. They made us feel so good. We walk in, oh, y'all look like the Obamas. We just wanted to be children of God. Amen. We didn't want to be up there. Amen. We just want to be sanctified people of God. Amen. Bringing the word of God unto them. 11. And whosoever shall not receive you nor hear you when ye depart, then shake off the dust under your feet for a testimony against them. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than that city. Amen. So Jesus was letting them know, if you go into a house and they don't receive you, amen, don't squabble with them. Amen. You just leave. Amen. Amen. Because so many God. Amen. And this scripture came to me as I was studying this lesson. Amen. It says, be not conformed. Don't be like the world. Don't put on the ways of the world. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Talking about that transgender, they need a renewing of the mind. Amen. Why? Because the mind wrong. Amen. You got to have the mind of who? The mind of Christ. If we get the mind of Christ, our walk gonna be right. Our talk will be right. Everything about us is going to be right. Why? Because we have a transformation of the mind. We got the mind of Christ. It say, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Jesus, amen, he was our perfect example. Verse 12. And it say, and they went out. Who went out? The disciples went out where Jesus told them. And they preached that men should repent. Amen. Repent means to be godly sorrow for the wrong that you have done. Repent means you won't do that ungodly thing anymore. Amen. And that's what we got to do. We got to strive to enter in at the straight gate. Amen. Say, when I would do good, evil was always present. It's like this flesh is a mess. It's a constant struggle. Amen. We got to fight against this flesh. Amen. When you go on a fast, if you are really keyed in on your fast, before you know it, what you do? Put something in your mouth. Amen. But y'all, I was a young saint in the Lord. I was 15 years old. I didn't really know too much about fasting, but going to prayer, they taught us how to fast. Amen. Total fast. Amen. Don't eat or drink anything. Amen. But praise God. One day, I was going about my daily business. Before I know it, I put something in my mouth. I had almost made it to 12 o'clock. Thanks of God, to God be the glory. I spit it out and I went to three.
All right.
The devil won't get no victory here.
Right.
Thanks of God, it's a constant fight. We got to fight against the devil. Amen. The devil is doing what he's supposed to do, but we got to do what we're supposed to do. Amen. God has charged us to be faithful witness, be victorious witness for him. When we are victorious witness, we are helping building up the kingdom of God. We don't want to tear the kingdom down, but what we want to help build God's kingdom up. Verse 13, and it say, and they cast out many devils. They cast out many devils. Amen. Who did that? The disciples, the apostles. They cast out many devils. Saints of God, you see how Jesus already knew that these were going to be productive disciples.
Yes.
They was going to turn things around. Yes. It said they cast out many demons and devils and anointed them and anointed with all many that were sick. Amen. Saints of God, how many know it's somebody to bless all?
My Lord.
Yes.
How many know, praise God? So many times when you're going through some stuff, you get that anointing off. I have drank some, y'all. I have drank some, and it'll do what you need it to do. I tell my granddaughters, when you take in your test, you anoint your head with oil. Amen. Why? Because God said he is a leader, he's a guider, he'll be right there when you need him to. Anoint yourself with oil. Amen. And he was telling them to anoint the sick with oil and heal them. They didn't heal them, but who do the healing? Jesus do the healing. Whatever we need is in God. Amen. A victorious kingdom. Saints of God, we are on the Lord's side. We want to be faithful witnesses. Why? Because we want the Lord to still have a victorious kingdom. Pray for me, saints.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Might let that one up. All right. That
come year round. I don't like to lose. How many of y'all love to lose? I never learned. Coach Stokes used to tell us, you lose a game, boy, and shake the boy's hand. Boy, I was in hand, but my heart sure wasn't there because I had lost. This is talking about a victorious kingdom. That's why I love being in God's kingdom. God always wins.
Amen.
I finally got where I need to be.
Yeah.
I've been finally got where you really need to be. Winning. I love to win. And the Lord Jesus Christ has never lost a battle. I like to be on his side. I refuse to be on any other side. Amen. Owning with God. That victorious means to win. It means to have dominion. It means to conquer. I always love that. I hate to lose anything. That's why I won so much when I was an athlete. Hallelujah. Can I brag a little bit? I played on the first football team to ever win a trophy for Blount. The first one. I love to win. I love to be where God wants me to be. Nothing wrong with that, y'all. The Bible let us know what is happening here in this lesson. Acts 1 and 8 said, you shall receive power. After that, the Holy Ghost will come upon you. If you don't have the Holy Ghost, it's a struggle for you. And you may do good for a while, but the Holy Ghost makes it easier.
Amen.
You shall receive power. When God sent the disciples out, he gave them what? Power. While Jesus was here, he gave certain power because why? He was here in the flesh. But now, when he left, you know what Mother Trinity said, that what? He told him to take different things with him because he wasn't here in the flesh no more. Although the same power was here, but you do things a little different when you don't have that, you know, you don't see him. A lot of men can't see him. Everybody understand what I'm saying? But he's right here. If you had that faith in him, then you can do it. But when he was here, he said, I'm giving you power. And they believed it because why? He was here in the flesh. But now he's not. You got to believe that he's in you, and you got to totally believe this. So the next time he told him, take your staff, take your shoes, take your coat. You know, take your money and your purse. Take all of this. Because he wasn't here in the flesh anymore. Then the word let us know too that the Holy Ghost will bring things to your remembrance. This is why you need the Holy Ghost to be a real witness for the Lord. To be in this victorious kingdom. St. John 14, I believe 26, and St. John 15, 26 tell you how God will be with you.
Yes.
This is what you need to witness. When you out there witnessing, I don't know whether y'all ever witnessed before. On the road, we've been out two by two. The old pastor used to try to do it just like the Bible said, send us out two by two. And we witnessed in Sierra Leone, Mother Christian and I, we both went together. When you got two, sometimes you're standing there trying to think of what you're going to say. twirling in your head, what am I going to say? But the Holy Ghost will bring it to you. You have the Spirit of God, it will bring it to you. Most of the time, sometimes that you haven't even studied what you're going over. God will bring you the answer right then and there. The lesson is right. What God was doing, he was getting his men ready. Jesus always respected. He always respected the Spirit. The Bible spoke of the Spirit first. Somebody said, well, why? Why Jesus just didn't, take the credit? Because he always respected the Spirit. His Spirit I'm gonna live it through God. And the word was God. The word was God. But this is what he wants us to do. Y'all remember, he did a lot of things for us. You are to respect the Spirit. Before you go out to witness, you ought to fall on your knees and ask God to word your mouth. Help me to do what I need to do. And say, speak through me, Lord. Ask the Lord. The minister have to do the same thing in the pulpit. Because you can feel when folks are not receiving. Sometimes you hear me say, well, y'all not really. Somebody's not ready. Because you can feel it. It will come to you. Then you know what to do. You ask God to send the word, Lord. And the minister have to know how to say it more than one way. In order, what? In order for everybody to get the message. Children, you preach to the children, you preach to some that is very educated. Sometimes you preach to some that is not as educated. So you have to say it in a way that everyone will pick up what you're doing. You have to do this the same way. And what you all are doing when you're witnessing, the same thing the minister do right here. But you're just teaching it. And some of us are teaching ministers. And you are teaching it to them. That's why some teachers pick it up in such a good way. They know how to do it because they have that basic how to teach. And you have to learn to do the same thing. And that's why it's good that you all come to the Sunday school. And you're going to have a jump on those who don't come. And that's what you want to do. This lesson is what? God had to get his disciples ready. Why? Because he's going to leave. He wasn't going to be here with them no more. I kind of gave you that illustration where he was what? He was here. He instructed them, told them what to do. But when he was gone, they got to do the